Modern America Dance Company has been bringing original productions to the stage for over four decades. To mark a milestone 40th year, they look to Washington University in St. Louis for inspiration.
We are taking our first steps in the research for a performance called Freedom. It's a collaboration with Washington University, Olin Library, and we're bringing their civil rights special collections to life through dance.
We're looking at pictures and films and trying to figure out where we're going to go with this project.
The Film and Media Archive is the home of the Henry Hampton Collection. And Henry Hampton was an independent African-American filmmaker who's best known for making Eyes on the Prize, and it's become the high watermark for African-American history and the civil rights movement.
Looking through the lens of Henry Hampton is a shocking glimpse of American history.
First of all, I'm having flashbacks because I was born in 1960, so I grew up in Alabama doing a lot of that, and I remember seeing images of that on television.
I think really gives us a more realistic glimpse as to the actual atrocities that were occurring at the time. It really just puts me there.
I was inspired by the pictures of lynching to create the first section because also saw the dancers reacting really strongly about it and emotionally. I'm using the image of the silk, sort of like the lynching. It is haunting us still today.
The one that spoke to me the most was the demonstrators. I think they were going across the Pettus Bridge, but they had a flag, I believe, and then there was clouds in the background. That one really spoke to me because it was just the sense of community moving toward something and the whole idea of movement.
I was really struck by the faces and the joyous faces that are the happiness and celebration of another person's murder and death. I really started asking the questions of how does a person get to a place where they think they're so much better to harm another person or even kill another person? And what is that division and separation? And do they feel remorse after that? Were their actions choices, or was it a sort of a product of environment?
I think all of us have experienced a situation where we've been stripped from something and how it affects us emotionally and how we communicate with other people when we see something like that happen. Do we turn the cheek or do we respond graciously?